Your 4 minutes starts now.
We do stage lighting and effects, and we actually offer the stage as well.
I'm concerned about your ability to compete.
Technically, I think he's passionate about what he does, and I think he's got the skills.
I think he just needs to do a few things that will make a big difference.
The one thing that I'm noticing in his presentations is that he is trying, as far as possible, to keep abreast of the technical side of things within his business.
So, does he stay?
Uyabona ke lomkhakha lona kwa ama event ke la ekhaya eminye ke inkundla ke lezi ke eziqasha abantu abasha mihla lena la ngaphandle ke futhi uphinde ukhumbule ukuthi ke amanani emsebenzi ke adala kuona ke lomkhakha lona abalelwa kwisibalo esidlula ngale kwa million usomabhizinisi wethu namhlanje sisebenzisana naye ke omunye ke wabantu abasebenza kuona ke lomkhakha lo lapha sikhuluma ngokuthi ke uma ngabe wena ufuna ukuzenzela kamadlela alihlazi kumele ube umuntu ke oqhashisa ngezinto esezingeni eliphezulu. Ngiyabona niyapakisha ngibona ipika nani kwenzakalani ngikiwapi?
We're going to a carnival, ne? So set up at it was an achievement. And such a big car.
You know, yeah, okay, we aim so high now. We so punctual and settings in white.
What's the plan to attract these new clients and to grow the business further?
We've tried to aim more at PCOs.
I love your business, I love your spirit.
My name is Sizwe Mokoena. I own a company called Ekurhuleni Entertainment. We offer technical services to event promoters, PCOs, which are professional conference organizers. What makes us unique is our ability to deliver timelessly and the ability and the flexibility to travel.
Namhlanje ngise Eastrand ekuRuleni yeFosloras kula khona ngizohlana nosomabhizinisi wethu engizobe ngichitha usuku naye. Igama lale nsizwe uSizwe. Inkampani yakhe ibizwa ngokuthiwa uGqozi. Uyabona ke lo mjita lona wenza lezi zinto lezi ekuthiwa wo sound hire nabo entertainment. Ayixoxisane naye ngizwe ukuthi ibhizinisi lakhe likhuluma ngani ke mangabe sikhuluma ngale zinto lezi esizibalile. Hola Skoko sam, angitshele kancane ngiyabona niyabhakisha ngibona ipika nani kwenzakalani ngikiwapi?
We're going to a carnival, ne? Mm-hmm. So set up at a but it's small, just two screens, a PA system and a stage.
Wow, yeah. Uthi into ezi-small but izinto eziningi ezihambayo.
No, ayisincane le.
Okay. Is it?
Yeah, but, le incane.
So yonke lento ye-carnival?
Yonke lento leyo izoyi carnival.
But uyibiza ukuthi incane.
Amarincane le, compared to where we want to go.
Selokushini njengamanje ngithi
showcase
ama client wa accessa kanjani ke especially abantu abangekho elokushini njengoba manje siya le Carnival City.
Okay, yabona njengoba sihleli manje ne masilibele senza ama events sinama flyer nama business cards esiwanikeza abantu. So lapho si spread information ngathi through word of mouth. And then there's obviously internet. Njoba sihlela uThabo lapha yani is doing a research.
Yeah.
He's our research guy.
Oh lapha kulela kulela
lela. Yeah, that's the office. Yeah, since Shaba so
it was okay.
He's finding out new clients. So he's building a database for us.
Yes.
Ama responsibility wami ukuthola ama gigs for ukuthi business irun kakhulu. Maybe get ama conference, ama events, people wanna hire just lighting. So they go through me kakhulu, contact them, nami contact ama company so we can get the business rolling.
Equipment yakho ubukeke ngathi yiningi, ingabe iyona yonke lena noma kukhona enye?
No, sisekhona esasele ngapha.
Isasekhona
esasele? Ya, ama light amaningi akhona ngapha, ya.
Uyigcina kuphi ke yonke le equipment?
Ihlala khona la jardini.
i-safety ne-security yakho enja ne-security yezinto ukuthi izohlala ikhona la.
Khona khona uyazama ukuthi uyenze i-security qini yabo. La endlini sinama camera, sine security company esigadayo.
Yes.
But still I mean safety mon equipment so is always top priority.
Yes sir.
Yabona because you know ukuthi everyone thinks they're sound engineers.
Mm-hmm.
So once bathola ukuthi kune-sound endlini eish.
Yeah, sure.
Mala, sure.
Yeah,
sure.
And then what about about insurance again?
No, we do have insurance.
Yeah.
Yeah, we do. I mean, I guess corner shall us have insurance. It's not a mal.
Yeah.
No, we end the checklist as it is pumile and job so set up a match.
Yeah.
Yeah. Uzo calculate about in as pumile. Uzo palo but masbuya as is check if to put his corner workshop foot is boy.
Yeah. Okay. Unjani as the owner, as the boss?
Yo, very friendly, straight mara yena yabo. Mara very friendly, humble guy, easy to work with. Yeah, umuntu nje wabantu yena kahle kahle.
The funding uyithathe vas khoko.
Bengi manager ye venue we carnival.
Yes sir.
I found out ukuthi there's a funding scheme yama EDs a carnival. I had to leave carnival for 2 years because they couldn't give me funding
while
I still working under their umbrella.
Oh.
So I got banned for 2 years from going there and working there.
Yeah.
Oh, toughest 2 years of my life. And then eventually the 2 years elapsed, yeah,
yes.
and luckily all the paperwork was ready. Name Mali Apuma again.
As a street tender, I've put I'm a client to Aqua, Abantu Abanja Nige. Who do you target and who do you cater for?
Usually in Zamuguti, Gashigashi Latin assist Funakona who cooperate.
Right.
Because even the equipment here is better suited
for my corporate
events.
Yes, sir.
So Sizamuguti stole Abantu Aba Pilang Ama events in Jengati.
Yes.
So if we PCO or a event organizer,
yeah,
that gives you your money.
Yes.
So Sizamuguti Sizaguwe because me and we share a common interest.
We are in corporate social investments, and our strategy focuses largely on youth. Now, this is a very youthful organization. Anyway, the services that they offer, being sound, lighting, and the technical aspects, you can imagine on sound. A lot of our events that we do for youth, and it's accompanied by sound. So take the Investec Soccer League that we run, and that he's assisted, provided service for us. Been very, very useful to have sound, to have beat, to have as people score goals, as people celebrate achievement. He's appealing to the way he's come from. Experience is key. Not only just work experience, but context, background experience, and that's why we've really loved working with this entity right through and through.
Ever since we started with the big events, Reservezali Ugozi. We started a concept of a business premium jazz festival that was in 2013, which was featured Zonke, Lead the Soil. And then this year, we've been doing well. The events are going to be
one, two.
We work as family. So in 2000, every time Harry Club work up pricing, we sit down, we discuss the budget on the look, and then they're very reasonable.
I've enjoyed spending this cut now. You want to know 70 Muslim for you. Nazne Green, Faith Mille.
Yeah, young kinti a 7.
Now, young kinti, I'm going to make sure I pick him for strong lap against of business.
Umbis.
I'm going to
cool.
Yeah.
Sharp, sharp.
Thank you.
Thank you, Siya.
Sharp, sharp. If you pull a kegas, you'll go to the Lipo. You'll go to the
Lipo. I thought I would become a professional soccer player. And then when Nglemalum Kolo, then I had to wait for 6 months before I could do anything else.
Sichitha usuku noSizwe lapha ebhizinisini lakhe. Uma suka lapha saphinde sabona ukuthi-ke ibhizinisi lakhe mihla namalanga kwenzakalani-ke kulona-ke. Saphinde futhi sathola-ke nethuba lokuthi-ke sike sichithe isikhathi ngokuyazi kabanzi-ke le nsizwa lena ephuma lena Ekurhuleni enekhono futhi lokudlala isiginci.
She's my African girl, African queen, she's my African king. From the way she loves me, look at the way she treats me. Look at the way she hugs me, look at the way she kisses me. She treats me like I'm an African queen.
What makes me happy? There's a lot of things that make me happy. Progress makes me happy. Meeting new people makes me happy. Seeing your vision grow from what it was to what it is now makes me happy. My guitar playing makes me happy.
Usizwe kushuthi uthanda nomculo ne-guitar.
Ugqozi nje yena yena self ugqozi. Impilo yakhe u-aim so high ngayo. So punctual emsebenzini wakhe. So harsh emsebenzini wakhe.
I mean like a normal kid, you know, young boy ufuna ukexperiment, you know, yahamba ugibele phezulu kwezindlu zabantu tshontsha amatayera because he winter ufuna ukufutha imali yabo, sibamba imbiba, besidlala amakite, you know, kakhulu kakhulu besidlala ibhola ke, you know, so I think what saved me from ukungagangi ukuthi bengisejimini ngidlala ibhola 6 o'clock ekuseni after school esikolweni 4 o'clock bengisejimini eclub.
Iphupho lakhe kahle bekukudlala ibhola ukuthi ayodlalela iKaizer Chiefs vele as vele ngisho ngithi ebholweni besinsimbo beseliphusha strong. Yeah,
bekalithanda ibhola, bekalidlala namanje nje bekasalidlala. Ngazorisekayekile kodwa ke ibhola lona bekalithanda.
Thought I would become a professional soccer player. And then when ngilemalumkolo, then I had to wait for 6 months before I could do anything else. In that interim, umamama uthi, okay, no ngeke ukhona ukuhlala nje ekhaya derhe. So maybe fake CV, wenze something in the meantime, usamele umkolo ukuthi uphe uphole. First CV, engena la Carnival, 4 months later I get a call. Was and it turned out ukuthi lento engiyenza la. So from that time I never looked back. Ngikhulele eFoslo, born and bred. In my life man yazi makhula in a typical township. Life being a grand fandiwane yabo.
Umkhulu wakhe bekangasebenzi, bekusebenza ugogo kuphela ekhaya. And ekhaya siyifamily enkulu.
Ugogo nomkhulu, they were blessed with 6 pairs of twins. So now you can imagine if it's 6 pairs of twins, it's already 12, plus yena nomkhulu is 14. Bese nabo bonke baba nabantwana ukuza phansi kanje. So at some point I think ekhaya I lived nabantu abanye abayi 31. If not 32 under the same roof.
So loko kuncane besikuthola bekufanele siphane sonke indlini singalali singadlanga. Wakhula ayazi naleyo nto. Noma siswele noma fika njengoba namanje akangafika sithi ukuthi akukho. Makane imali uyakhipha thi siyothenga sidle sonke.
It wasn't a well to do family. You know, we just got by gogo nomkhulu bahereza, you know.
Zilambile lingane simbashile
akahleki nje ngomsebenzi umuntu nje ohashi uyanakekela makungekho lutho uyanakekela nje empilweni
baleka wenduta uyabaleka wenduta.
From the time I started my working career, which was I think late 1999 or 2000, I never took leave and went and sat home in that time until it was 2010, I think, during the World Cup. So I always took leave to go and freelance in the industry somewhere.
Uqala kwakho ukusebenza wangithengela iheater ye 1000 rand.
Usizo kahle kahle into engingakutshela yona into makathi uyayifuna uzoyenza. Angeka jika angeka yelena le noma imali ingekho imara le akutshele yona ukuthi sibalingi zoyenza into kanje uzoyenza
waqhubeka ke kwathi umakhelwane sekhaya wa ngathi ngile ekhaya makaqeda ukuthenga idodge wathi lo baba mina ngijabulanga ukuthi umntana akho athenga azothenga imoto enkulu kanje unganandawo yokuhlala ngathi mina baba asibone ngoba mina nawe asinayo imali ngeke sibhadale le moto engaphandle wena ungenaphi lapha athi baba hayi mina angendawo mara kodwa wena awunandlu ngathi mina anginandaba baba nawe amehlo sizobona indlu yeza
it was an achievement ukuqala ukuthi ukhona ukuthenga indlu and such a big car you know obviously ekhaya beba proud although I never told them until I had all the papers on my position and I knew this was now my house
weza lo baba wangiqhawula wathi hayi ngiyakubongisa ke uNkulunkulu wakho umntana akho uthengile indlu kwaba kuza kwami ke ngizohlala kule ndawo
utala bengitshela
aw
utala bengitshela oh baby ngiyakutshela ke ngiyathanda baby
baningi abantu abashala ngaphandle njengosizwe nabo kabayisunguleleke amabhizinisi afana njengaleli lakhe besebenzela lapha emakhaya kodwa ke inkinga ezinye ababhekana nazo ukuthi ke bayobamba kanjani ukuthi asimame lamabhizinisi abo uyabona ke uma ngabe ke wena ufuna ukuzakhela igama kona lomkhakha lo komele ukuthi ke izinto zakho zibe seqophelweni eliphezulu futhi usebenze ngokukhulu ukuyimisela nokuthi abantu bakuthembe uyabona usizwe omunye ke babantu abafunge bagomela ukuthi bona bazophokophela kuona lomkhakha noma ke khona ke ama challenges abhekisene nawo
Hi sengifikile Bongo TV ngizobona uPepsi angazi ukuthi uzongibuzani the weather is nice let's see how it goes it promises to be a nice day
On the hot seat today Kiblomeli Sizwe who describes himself as a township hustler number 1 Knox man Welcome to the show, brother.
Sawubona mfethu.
Ukrind.
Khona kunjani?
Sharp sharp.
Sharp sharp.
Tudafatsi munna.
Thank you.
So, 7 years ago, you started in this industry. Akir, unospana in this industry for a few years and then decided to start your own business. Was that a good idea?
Yeah, it was. Though I think it's more than 7 years ago. I started in 2000, early.
Working for somebody else?
Working for somebody else. Yeah, and then I worked throughout. I was in Carnival City for about 8 years. Left Carnival and went to a company called MGG, and it was in Eden Vale at the time. And then after having experienced and my childhood dream coming through, I just wanted to start a business.
Okay, and this was your the childhood business. Dream? A business or was it this type of business specifically?
No, it was a business. Not this one because I didn't know this industry when I grew up. You know, it's something engithole when I came into my job at Carnival City.
Okay. Wenza malini ke?
Sure, it depends ukuthi ngibuza nini. If you ask me that question in December and in June it would be two different sort of turnovers.
So December?
December because we come from the peak season which we call the silly season it starts from around August all the way till about mid December yeah you'd make a good say just over 100
okay per month
well it depends how much you hustled but you would yeah
okay and then June
is mostly the quiet month so you are around 25-30
okay
yeah
so I saw your car mangena lana one
yeah
karanya ne fancy nyana so but at the same time so clearly you know ukhona ukuhola but at the same time you're struggling ngebaki yespani and secure transportation do you have your priorities in order
no look It's a bit of a touch and go situation. That car I bought while I was still at my previous job while I was working. You know, the idea was to trade in the car for a bucky, but I think the car sort of works better because it can put more people in the car and you can tow a trailer and go to an event.
Or else if I get a truck, I'll still need another truck. I still need another vehicle because then the truck is a driver plus two passengers. No, I've had to, you know, it's been my struggles. I've had to work through this thing to see. I would have let go. I promise you, I would have.
Because, double cab?
The double cab's got a smaller back base. But the point, I would have tried and I would have let go because I still risked it. When I left my job to start the company, I had the car and I still owed it. So it was in the line anyway. So I said, my company weighs better than the car. So if they repossess the car, which they did even, you know, and then God being great, I got it back. But I did put it in the line, I did.
What does the business need in order to grow to the next level?
I think where we're standing now, we need more business because I think from here we can grow purely by getting more business that obviously will ascertain that we get more experience and more on-the-job sort of experience.
So have you considered, for instance, Ka December, maybe doing your own events? Because one of the biggest costs Mawian's event is your gear and your equipment.
Technical. Yeah. We actually do our own events, but they normally community-based events. So it's just us purely showing the people that there's another industry and then getting up-and-coming artists to come and perform at our events. But we usually just do it for free.
But I'm not sure if you're in a position to be doing pro bono work just yet.
I think there's big potential and growth in giving as well, you know, just taking is fine, but I grew up from a very big family who taught me to give. Yeah.
Half the tax.
The tax is a must. You have to pay your taxes. So I don't see that as giving. That's something you have to do. You know, you have to give from the bottom of the heart in order for you to get.
What's the plan to attract these new clients and to grow the business further?
We've started with a marketing campaign where we're trying, instead of just aiming at everyone and thinking everyone is a potential client, we've tried to aim more at PCOs and marketing,
PCOs?
Professional conference organizers, because those are the people that do events on a daily basis and who can value what we do.
Okay, fantastic. Yeah. I love your business. I love your spirit.
Thank you.
I think you might need an accountant and maybe somebody to give you advice around operations. So I'm going to send you off to have a chat with a friend of mine, and then afterwards you have an opportunity to pitch to a panel of judges, and we'll see how that goes.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
Sizwe is really up to something good, but we all know that hustling can only take you up to a certain point. At some point, you have to become a little bit more organized. You have to become a bit more formal as a business. So I'm sending him off to a coaching session with Thuli Magubane to see if she can help him turn some of those hustle plans and things and moves and whatever into tangible plans to help grow his business.
Sure. Yes, and like I thought it went very well, although being tugile kancane, you know. But yeah, I think I did well. And I think I impressed kancane lapha. Well, look, I expect Usisithuli to help me with my marketing and sales strategy, which I think I have. She will have to look through it and see if it's proper, and then she can tell me what she thinks, and then from then take it forward. We just want to grow in size.
So, but size can't be your only vision. There needs to be something beyond that drives you.
If that's not strategy enough, I don't know what it is.
Ake sibone ukuthi uThuli noSizwe i-coaching session yabo ihambe kanjani.
Let's meet this week's coach.
My name is Thuli Magubane, and I'm a director and founder of Mint Fresh Advisory Services. And it's a company that's focused on management consulting, One of our key areas is strategy and doing any work that's strategic, from business cases, business plans, restructures. Well, entrepreneurship, I guess it's something that's in my blood and I'm an entrepreneur myself, and I think over the last couple of years I've become more passionate to see more people get into business and succeed in business. What qualifies me to be a coach and making moves? I have a diverse set of skills. I've got financial skills, operational skills, strategy skills. I'm also quite a well-networked individual. In helping entrepreneurs, connecting them to the right people, it's something that I'm able to do. A man without a vision is a man without a future. And a man without a future always returns to his past. So in everything that I do, I always make sure that I'm working towards a vision and I'm moving forward.
Entrepreneurs are smart risk takers, but they need someone with the knowledge to guide their steps in the right direction.
Where are you at? What is your thinking? How do you want to take your business to the next level?
What we're doing now is we're going hard on our marketing and sales campaigns. We're creating a marketing strategy, and we're hoping from that comes some sort of growth.
And then another issue you had mentioned earlier is trying to get a truck or a bucket for your business. And if you're saying you're doing one event a week, is it really worth it to get a loan when you're using that bucket once or twice a week? Whereas if you rent out, you could be spending a lot less than what a monthly installment would be on that bucket.
Yeah, you know, the way you would look at it, when we say events, there's you can scale the events down. Sometimes you're just picking up an extra piece of equipment that you bought. You know, you don't need to now go and rent the truck to go get a piece of truss that you bought and that won't fit into your car. Or you're just taking things to service. You know, so it's those kind of things. So there is a daily use need for the truck, not just going to events. No,
I'm a skills. With business is one thing I think we see on I. And dating I am trying to sevens and I. And then obviously there's also the rental of the equipment. So would you not rather get a loan to get additional equipment so that you don't have to rent it out and you could possibly rent out that equipment to other people and get additional revenue?
Yeah, look, I mean, even the biggest companies in the country would still go out and rent some kind of equipment, because it's never really the same size events. So as you grow in the business, you elevate from one size events to the next size events.
Do you have a business strategy?
We have a vision, which is Vision 2020, which then...
Okay, Vision 2020.
Yeah.
You sound like a government department.
If the government can do it, those are people
so what
who
is
are
vision,
100 times
what's
smarter
vision,
than us.
What's
you know,
Vision 2020?
We just want to grow in size to a point where we can do... events to the size of the Summer Awards or the Metro Awards, because that ideally is the size that can handle most international conferences coming into the country.
You can't make your vision just an event. So what happens after that?
No, it's not an event. Mm. You're missing the point.
No, I'm
Vision
just,
2020 I'm just... is a size of the company which is able to host the summers. It's not that we're aiming for the summers. What happens if the summers get cancelled and whoever's sponsoring the event doesn't sponsor it in 2020?
So
it's the size of the company then.
So, but size can't be your only vision. There needs to be something beyond that drives you.
If that's not strategy enough, I don't know what it is.
But if you had to get 20 new clients, given your regular business, I mean, are your systems, you know, in place to be able to handle that? Is your billing in place? If you say, you know, you want to grow to the scale where you can handle an event the size of the summers, you know, obviously that's competing with the big guys. So you need to be able to compare, you know, apples to apples. So what that says to me is your business is not ready yet. You need to put the structures in place to get to that. So you said you have additional people.
We're not ready for 20 more clients. 10 more we are.
Are you not contradicting yourself then? You're saying that
you know, you don't want to take on too much work, but then at the same time you're saying you want to grow.
It depends how you view too much work. To me, 20 is too much, 10 is manageable.
I think Sizwe Mokoena, he still has the startup mentality.
I own the company, but in another sense, we all own it because I have a team of people who I just spread the information and I say, go do that, and they go do it successfully all the time.
You need to prepare for a pitch. There's a lot of money at stake there. And only 4 places at the final.
Yes.
So you need to make sure that you're one of the 4. Amen. So what are you pitching, and do you need any pointers?
I need to be one of the 4. I would ideally love to get 2 more computers, because at the moment, even our computers go out at gigs and come back and do office work. So while we're at gigs, we pick up viruses and stuff like that. Then we bring back into our main system at the office, which then is not really healthy. At the moment, I think we're holding by a thread. So if I had to pitch for the 50, I'd probably get 2 more laptops who would sit in the office and concentrate on the sales and marketing and the admin side of the business. And then, yeah, most definitely increase my phone bill by however much I get from there, but rigorously attacking on the sales and marketing.
Umozo pitch afanele ukuthi ube clear ukuthi leyo mali uzoyisebenziselani.
I think uthuli uyawazi umsebenzi wakhe, ne? One, I have to say that. I think if we took it from here, siyaqhubeka nayo, we'll get to a lot more in terms of helping my company. It's just that the time frame that is saying
Making Moves has a prize valued at 50,000 rand to invest into a business. 12 young entrepreneurs will get a chance to showcase their businesses. Each entrepreneur will be given a chance to pitch for this investment to our panel of judges. The judges will use their own discretion to pick the top 4 businesses to go into our final episode, where they will compete for this grand prize. You too can be part of this exciting opportunity for young entrepreneurs. Sizwe is about to pitch for a spot in the top 4. Only 2 places are left. Remember, the final 4 will pitch for a chance to win 50,000 rand investment in the last episode.
Hey, Inzi Malento, you know, but I'm glad because there's been paradigm shifts in the way I used to see my business and the way I saw my strategy. After Kulumano Sithuli, she's tough. I prepared how and where I'm gonna use the 50,000 rand. I also tweaked my strategy because I think from what came out yesterday that I needed to tweak a little bit more on it. So I did some tweaking, we'll see how it goes.
Our third judge is Martine Solomon, managing member at Mzansi Risk Advisors. She's an accredited life assurance, short-term insurance and healthcare broker.
Ita?
Sanbona.
Shabunjan Fitch.
Kona gunjan Fitch.
Sure. Number one Knox man.
Sure.
Are you ready?
I think I am, yeah.
Yeah? Have you had time to think since our conversation?
I did. I slept quite late last night, actually.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm impressed. I hope your presentation will blow us away. I'd like to introduce you. You know Thuli on my left?
Yes, I met Thuli.
You've had a chance to have a coaching session with her?
Yeah,
we did. Which I hope was helpful.
We did yesterday. Very nice. We did. Thank
Good.
You.
Good. Martine on my right?
Good afternoon.
How you doing?
Good, thanks.
I'm all right, thanks.
All right, so you have got 4 minutes. Your 4 minutes starts now.
All right, thank you. The presentation is presented by me, Sizwe Mokoena, who is the founder of Ukozi Entertainment. A little bit of intro into what we do and about us. We offer PA systems, audiovisual screens and projectors and cameras. We do stage lighting and effects, and we actually offer the stage as well. We are a group of individuals who are strong-willed, flexible. We know what we do by virtue of having done this for a long time. We're very hardworking, we're very professional, we're punctual. We have the service genes, which means we will serve. We're very reliable. If you give us one call and you drop it in your in our hands, we'll do it. We do repeat business very well. Our weak point is that we're too trusting doing events for people before they pay us. Very touchy, because then if you think of government work, then makes you think again. However, where we're going is to our vision, which is Vision 2020, where we see ourselves as one of the best black technical company in the country and beyond, measurable by the size of what we had become, and the employees, equipment, community programs, and probably the networks we would have built then. How we get there is, instead of just aiming at everyone as a potential client, we're focusing our focus to specific markets. So we're only targeting PCOs, corporate people, marketing managers at companies that value what we do. One reason we do that is that we believe that there's no black technical suppliers in that fraternity in the corporate. Two is because I believe that we are more than capable to handle and deliver in those areas. Three, because that's where our growth lies. You know, that's where our strength will become better and better. What we are currently doing to get there is, we have just started our sales and marketing campaigns targeted specifically at these individuals, powering up our web content in terms of websites and social media. We are hiring staff to help where there's gaps, especially at this marketing and sales. What we need is access to market, resources, both human and material, as many adverts as we can afford for now, and more marketing tools in terms of buying advertising space in some events that we do if they have screens. What we plan to do if we win the 50,000 Rand is, we will get, for 30,000 Rand, we'll get two high-tech laptops that will service our more sophisticated clientele at the corporate level. For 30,000 Rand, we will then get two left page adverts in Screen Africa or ProMag magazine, which is the magazine for our industry. Apparently they charge differently for left hand and right hand adverts on their pages. With the remaining 5,000, we'll just buy business cards and get Tabo an email, just make him comfortable at our premises. Thank you.
Fantastic. You finished right on time. Good presentation.
I timed it.
We are now going to get feedback, and you're going to receive some questions. I will start with you, Thuli, as the person that has the most knowledge of the company.
The business. Okay. Sizwe, I think for me, question is, do you really need to spend 30,000 on laptops? Because I think these days, laptops, even for, you know, the high-end laptops, paying 15,000 rand a laptop is quite on the high side.
Yeah, look, reason I did specify high-tech laptops is because we're going into a field that will require software for what they do. I mean, if you look at where we're trying to go in corporates, everything that they do there is not just for your typical, or with your typical technical company or laptop that's at home you can find.
There are lots of companies that do what you do. And I'm concerned about your ability to compete. What's going to make you different, other than the fact that you're black?
We want to be booked because of merit, because we know we can do this and we can actually deliver. In saying that, if I had to go head to head with my competition, any that you can mention at this point, I would actually lose, because then I would go and compare equipment and the size and the truck and how much spend they got, which I don't have currently. But I can brag about my people and our values that we have, because it's easy for me to sort of share my values, and they filter all the way down. So regardless of who you're speaking to in my company, I'm confident that you'll probably get the same smile that you get from me. You'll get the same friendliness and the same sort of service gene.
Regarding your advertising, you'd like to spend some money on advertising. I'd just like to know what advertising you're currently doing for the business.
We're currently on social media. We started because of budget stopped sending out mailers. We had a database of client potential and existing clients that we were sending monthly mailers to, and then we had budget constraints, and then we had to sort of put that on hold.
Time is up. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much.
All right.
I'm a little bit relieved that it's done, but I can't help but worry about the outcome. And I'm not really a patient person, you know. When I do something, I need to know the outcome and get it then. That's why we can do what we do, you know. I don't know, man, it's a touch and go situation. At this point, I'm glad that I took their advice and did what they say. It was relatively questions that I expected that they asked. But I don't know, I mean, sometimes they ask you a question, but it's not, they're not expecting the answer you have in your head. They were going somewhere else with it, you know, just trying to test how much or how far you know. But like I say, man, when there's more than two characters, there's always going to be a clash. You just need to speak to the person to find out.
Okay, so we've heard the young man's pitch. It's time for us to deliberate and discuss, you know, whether we think you should stay and move on to the next round, and also discuss what pointers we should be giving him. So, Tuli, let's start with you.
For me, having spent time with Sizwe, I get a sense that he's only just realized that he needs to focus on the sales and marketing. And there hasn't been enough research and thought in terms of what that sales and marketing strategy actually needs to look like. Technically, I think he's passionate about what he does, and I think he's got the skills. It's just maybe rounding up that sales and marketing and making sure that it is well-drafted, well-focused, and is targeting the right people.
I think he's got all that he needs. And the one thing that I'm noticing in his presentations is that he is trying as far as possible to keep abreast of the technical side of things within his business, which is comforting. Then there's the, you know, the emotional intelligence side, where he's been absolutely spot on that he needs to set aside or stand out from the rest in terms of the service that he delivers, which is very important to me because service delivery is quite a problem in the marketplace at the moment. I'm concerned about the sales and marketing aspect. I don't think that he's got clear guidelines of where his growth strategy needs to be pegged, because he hasn't, you know, he was very open in saying that he hasn't tracked where his business has actually come from. And I'm talking about existing and previous business. That worries me because he's spending quite a chunk of the money on advertising. He could have got quite a chunk of business from social media, but he's not aware of it. And yeah, I don't know if he has clear direction on what he wants to achieve by spending that amount of money on that platform, and whether the platform is actually what he needs within the business.
So does he stay? Does he come back?
I think
back?
So.
Okay, he comes back. I keep being voted out.
What's your view?
You guys, I wouldn't bring him back.
And your reason?
I think he just needs to do a few things, a handful of things, that will make a big difference.
You make a very good point.
So the question becomes, do we ask him to come back in the next round? Let's bring him back in and deliver the news.
Yo, I don't know. I don't know why I'm getting excited. You know, I expect to be in the finale on the last four. I need to be there. I should be there. I have to be there. I'm generally a very positive person, so I can't sink back and let my thoughts take me aback. Let's go.
Ooh. Welcome back, sir.
Thank you.
Yeah, how do you think you did?
You know, I'm not sure. Your face is so straight, I can't tell. Personally, I think I did fairly well. I guess you just have to tell me.
Okay. I think, and I think we all think, you did very well.
Thank you.
We have some feedback for you. It's long, so I'm not going to get into long reasons about why. I'm just going to tell you what to do.
All right.
Go and do it, and your business will grow.
Thank you.
Right. And it's not just my thinking, it's our collective thinking. Right? Go. There's something called enterprise development. All right? And lots of companies have to comply. I want you to go to all the big events companies that you can find. The likes of Blue Moon Communications, VWV, Ann Williams, etc., etc. Make a hit list of all of them. Okay. Prepare your showreel and go to each one of them and say, you guys use technical suppliers, you do big corporate events, we'd like to become a supplier. Here's a video, pictures of work that we've done. Here's the equipment that we have, here are our values. Give us an opportunity. That's the first thing you gotta do, go. Okay. There are tons of them and they do big corporate work, and with the new BEE codes, they need to be empowering young black business. So go. So, the long and short of it is, you're not gonna get any money from us, right? And I'll tell you why. You deserve it. You should be getting money from us. But we've got to look at the whole season and look at all the entrepreneurs coming through and say, where will that money make the most impact? Right?
Okay.
Firstly. Secondly, who can use that money the most? I think the value of this experience has been, go and take the advice we've given you. Go and do it, and your business will grow. So 50 grand will make a temporary impact on your business. Go and implement the things that we've told you to do, and it will grow your business.
Okay, thank you. Sure.
It's always sad when you have to tell somebody they haven't made it through, because obviously expectations have been put forward and it's been building up. And you mentioned, you know, he stayed out till late putting together his presentation, and I think in his mind he could already see the 50,000 in his bank account.
I was hoping to get maximum exposure from this, use it as part of my marketing sort of skill and tool, and then put it on my exhibitions which are coming up now, and just punt it and see how far I get with it. What's happened, it's a lesson, and it was a nice thing, experience. I liked it, thank you.
Sizwe couldn't make the cut, but we wish him and Ukozi all the best. Watch next week as we bring you another story of Mzansi's young entrepreneurs. We'll be right back.